video takes you on a tour of the St. Croix Crossing Project between the city of Oak Park Heights, Minnesota, and the town of St. Joseph, Wisconsin. These computer renderings animate the design concepts of the project from aerial, land, and water perspectives, and highlight many of the project's sensitive areas and design features. The St. Croix Crossing Project was developed by a 28-member stakeholder group, which arrived at a consensus on such main concerns as the environment, cultural resources, community values, and transportation. A subgroup of the stakeholder group, the Visual Quality Review Committee, or VQRC, further defined the project by providing aesthetic recommendations that are contained in the project's visual quality manual. The VQRC employed a context-sensitive design approach to the St. Croix Crossing project, balancing good highway design with the contextual features of the area. The recommendations of the VQRC were later refined by the Stillwater Lift Bridge Advisory Committee in the area around the lift bridge, and also by the Visual Quality Advisory Committee around the New River Bridge. Starting at the west end of the project, the Oak Green Greeley intersection will be rebuilt and shifted slightly to the east to provide a better local roadway alignment. The frontage roads will be moved away from the main intersection and realigned to improve traffic operations. The St. Croix Crossing Project extends along Highway 36 in Minnesota and Highway 64 in Wisconsin. The project also includes a new bridge crossing over the St. Croix River, establishing a project length of approximately 7 miles. The Osgood intersection will be reconstructed by retaining its basic layout, but additional turn lanes will be provided to improve operations. To reduce the openness of Highway 36 in this commercial area, the VQRC recommended planting a variety of native grasses, shrubs, and small and large trees in the spaces along frontage roads and on the boulevards of local streets. The larger shade trees would line the outer edge of the frontage roads, while the smaller trees, shrubs, and grasses would be used closer to the roadways to provide visual interest while minimizing safety and maintenance concerns. East of Osgood Avenue, Highway 36 transitions from the commercial area to the St. Croix River Valley. The median narrows, and the outer edges allow more space for landscaping. The Beach Road Bridge passes over Highway 36 and represents a gateway to the St. Croix National Scenic Riverway, connecting the upper and lower portions of the city of Oak Park Heights while framing the project's new signature bridge over the St. Croix River. Along the west side of the river, Highway 95 provides access to the city of Bayport to the south and to the historic downtown Stillwater area to the north. The Highway 95 interchange will be reconstructed with a diamond interchange configuration, providing easy access to both north and southbound Highway 95. In the interchange area, extensive landscaping will reestablish the wooded character of the bluff line. The plantings will include dense stands of native trees and shrubs along roads and ramps. Over time, the vegetation will attain sufficient height and density to screen portions of the interchange from the St. Croix overlook, the river, and adjacent neighborhoods. The historic Log Cabin Restaurant, now known as Club Terra, is on the south side of Highway 36. And just north of the highway in this area is the St. Croix overlook. Both properties were constructed in the 1930s and are listed on the National Register of Historic Places. Mitigating elements have been incorporated into the design to offset impacts to these and other historic properties affected by the project. Stormwater treatment ponds have been constructed throughout the project in Minnesota and Wisconsin. 4 of them are located in the Highway 95 interchange area. 6 other ponds are located in Minnesota, and another 6 ponds will be located in Wisconsin. These stormwater ponds positively affect the area's water quality by removing the sediments and nutrients from the rainwater before it enters the St. Croix River. Beyond the Highway 95 interchange is the New River Crossing's signature bridge. An extradosed bridge is characterized by straight cables and relatively short towers, in combination with box girders that support the driving surface. The extradosed bridge type was selected because its distinctive style best balances the different features and requirements of the project with the area's unique historic and natural environment. Based on the recommendations of the Visual Quality Advisory Committee, the roadway and trails on the river bridge will be lit to provide a safe crossing for trail and roadway users, along with navigation and aviation lighting. The bluffs of the St. Croix River rise abruptly 200 feet above the river's narrow shoreline on a heavily wooded slope and are a critical component of the riverway scenery. Wisconsin's Highway 35 bridge is just a short distance back from the bluff line and is a transition point between the river valley and the farm fields to the east. Landscaping along the Wisconsin roadways provides linear bands of trees and shrubs to replicate the hedgerows that mark fence lines, roads, drives, and ditches in this primarily agricultural landscape. This interchange provides access to Wisconsin Highway 35 to the west and St. Croix County Highway E to the east. Once the project is completed, County Highway E near the Holton Elementary School and a portion of Highway 35, which will be bypassed by the project, will become local roadways. The interchange bridge will be a two-span, pre-stressed concrete beam bridge, similar to the bridge at 150th Avenue. The eastern limits of the St. Croix Crossing project tie into the existing Highway 35 and Highway 64 four-lane roadway near 150th Avenue. For the westbound driver in Wisconsin, the visual field will narrow as the roadway begins to descend into the river valley. At this point, landscaping closes in on the roadway, giving the driver a visual clue to slow down as they approach the river bridge. The Highway 35 bridge acts as a gateway to the St. Croix National Scenic Riverway. As the driver passes under the Highway 35 bridge, the view shed dramatically opens to the river valley and the New River Bridge. A loop trail, approximately 5 miles long, will be constructed as one of the project's mitigation items. Located on the north side of the new river bridge, the loop trail will connect to local and regional trails in Minnesota and Wisconsin, and will cross the lift bridge. After the new river bridge opens, vehicular traffic will be transferred, and the lift bridge will be converted to a pedestrian and bicycle facility, and will still accommodate boat navigation. The aesthetic recommendations in and around the lift bridge have been refined by the Stillwater Lift Bridge Advisory Committee. Trail users will experience scenic landscapes characterized by farmlands, wooded bluffs, river terraces, an archaeological district, and the historic downtown Stillwater area. Several vistas and interpretive sites will be available along the route. The loop trail will connect with other trails that will be built by the project along Highway 95 and along the Highway 36 South Frontage Road and in Wisconsin, tying the loop trail into other local and regional trail systems in both states. The trails will increase pedestrian and bicyclist access in the area and will provide varied recreational opportunities. The Lower St. Croix River was added to the National Wild and Scenic Rivers Act in 1972. The river, as a recreational area, is also considered a 4F property under the Transportation Act of 1966. Because the riverway is federally protected by both of these laws, the project has been developed and reviewed by both the National Park Service under Section 7A and by the Federal Highway Administration under Section 4F of the appropriate acts. An act of Congress and a presidential signature in 2012 authorized the project under the Wild and Scenic Rivers Act. The bridge design has been developed to minimize environmental impacts wherever possible by conserving naturally occurring communities and features, such as mussel beds within the river, a high-quality wooded wetland along the Minnesota shoreline, and the river bluffs along both sides of the St. Croix. The bridge design also minimizes environmental impacts by limiting the number of bridge piers that are constructed in the river. In Minnesota, Highway 95 will be rebuilt as a 4-lane divided roadway from the north city limits of Bayport to just north of the Sunnyside Marina entrance, a distance of about 1.5 miles. Traffic signals will be provided at Pickett Avenue and at the North and South Highway 36 ramp intersections. A trail follows the west side of Highway 95 in Bayport to Pickett Avenue. It then crosses Highway 95 and meanders along the east side of the roadway, continuing north until it meets up with the loop trail. A trail connection to the west establishes trail access to the Oak Park Heights and Stillwater commercial areas along Highway 36. The next steps for this project include continued construction and implementation of mitigation items.